You can stay, Craig says softly, looking at Sophie, but don't get in our way, and don't smoke anything else while you're here. She walks up to Robin and whispers something in his ear. He pulls his phone out of his pocket, looks at it, then nods. Robin turns and goes back over to Sophie. Finn's mum is here, and I'm going to go with her to his flat. We need to look for anything that can help us work out what's going on.
You can't do that, Sophie exclaims. That's an invasion of privacy. Police can't break into anywhere they want.
Robin looks at her, a withering expression on his face. I'm not going as police, I'm going as his friend, and Josie has a key, so we're not breaking in. He pauses. Would you prefer that Finn stays here, Sophie, locked in a van with a dead body threatening to kill himself? Sophie reels at the stark reality. But she shakes her head quickly, stunned.
I'm coming with you, she stutters.
You can come if you want, but if you get in my way, I will arrest you, like I should have done 3 months ago.
Robin's voice is dispassionate, his emotions back under check. Sophie doesn't know how he does it, but she feels sad for Robin. She'd rather be herself, emotional and reactive and feeling, experiencing the world as it happens, than be that cold.
Do you understand me? Robin adds.
Sophie bites her lip, nodding slowly.
Fine, then let's go.
6.
Robin feels warm arms round him, pulling him tight. He enjoys the closeness for a second, remembering the familiar scent of lavender talcum powder, then pulls away, kissing his best friend's mum on the cheek. Josie looks tired, but her presence is the tonic Robin needs. She puts two hands either sides of Robin's face and looks at him closely, a kind smile radiating towards him.
Let me look at you, Robin, Josie says. It's been too long.
She pulls him first in one direction, then the other. Robin is used to being examined in this way by Josie and lets her prod him in the tummy.
You're looking good.
That's your way of saying I've lost weight, he replies good-naturedly.
Well, you had spare, Josie says, and Robin snorts. I'm sorry we haven't seen you since Georgia died, she continues. I tried to call.
Let's talk later, Robin interrupts awkwardly.
He pulls away from Josie and receives a second embrace from Sandra, standing next to them. He towers over her, his 6 foot compared to her barely 5. It's been nearly 6 years since he saw them last, at George's funeral. Josie's tall and slender, her build the same as her son's, her grey hair now short and cropped. In contrast, Sandra's got rounder, her rosy cheeks surrounded by a halo of ash blonde curls. It's his fault he hasn't seen them. He'd ignored Josie's calls, not wanting to talk about what happened, how Georgia died, entombed in his cocoon of misery.
You'll sort this, won't you, Robin? Sandra says quietly, and he nods, despite his reservations.
Robin points to Sophie, who's receiving a hug from Josie.
Sandra, this is Sophie, Finn's girlfriend, Robin says, doing a quick introduction.
The women all smile at each other, but then expressions turn serious as Craig comes over. Robin waits impatiently as she spends precious moments outlining the situation to the older women. Sharp's death, Finn locked in the van, the confusion and lack of clarity over what's going on.